My father, who was apparently a great miner, in the days before mechanization and so on, when you got the great seam, there's a great seam, a famous seam, a world-famous one, which I believe is called the Great Atlantic Fault, and it starts in northern Spain, in the Basque country, and it goes under the Bay of Biscay, and it comes up in South Wales, and it goes under the Atlantic and comes up in Pennsylvania. So that if you took a Basque miner or a Welsh miner or a Pennsylvania miner, and if you could blindfold them and transport them, and they know the coal face the minute they saw it, I believe it's 4 feet 6 inches. And my father used to talk about it as some men will talk about women, talk about the beauty of this coal face. And my brothers would tell me stories about my father, who would look at the seam. My father's a very short man, an ideal height for a miner. He was about 5 feet 3 or 4, very, very powerful, of course. And he would look at the seam of coal, and he would, as to almost surgically, make a mark on it, and then ask his boy. Every miner has a boy who works for him, and he would say, "Give me the number 2 mandrel." That's a half-headed pick. And then, having stared at this gorgeous display of black shining ribbon of coal, he would then hit it with one enormous blow, and if he hit it right, something like 20 tons of coal would fall out from the coal face.
Really?
So that it was thrilling, it was exciting. And indeed, that's why I think when you perhaps think of me as being born with a silver spoon and so on, miners believed themselves anyway, to be the aristocrats of the working class. They felt superior to all other kinds of manual laborers. They were skilled workers. That coal face was a magical creature.